Now, 20 years ago, huge protests were held across the UK calling for the rights of disabled people to be protected and promoted. This led to what's now seen as a landmark law, the Disability Discrimination Act.
But two decades on, and campaigners say full equality is still a long way off. Our disability news correspondent, Nicki Fox, has been looking back at how the legislation helped to change lives.
Jason is a renowned artist. His work portrays life as a disabled person. One day in the early 80s, after spending a long time in hospital, his brother took him to the pictures to cheer him up.
He said, I'm going to take you to see Jaws 1 and 2. It was a double billing, so it was really good. We got to the cinema, the manager came out, didn't make any eye contact, and he kind of pointed at me and said, well, he can't come in, he's a fire hazard. So this is the...
Jason reflects experiences like this in his work.
So this piece is a piece I did that hangs in Westminster Hall.
Using his talent to highlight the frustration he felt at the time.
He couldn't complain because there wasn't anything in statute to complain about. It was basically, you put up with it.
Civil rights for disabled people!
It was during the early 90s, disabled people decided enough was enough. Thousands took to the streets to protest.
Do you realise what you're doing here?
One of those arrested was Agnes Fletcher.
Can you paint me a picture of the day?
Oh, it was just incredibly exhilarating and exciting.
The demonstrations led to a general sense of outrage, and eventually the Disability Discrimination Act was passed.
It was incredibly symbolic that finally this concept, this idea of discrimination against disabled people was recognised in law, you know, so it all stems from there. And there have been massive changes since then over the 20 years as a result of that legal change.
Although the bill was weaker than many campaigners had hoped for, fundamentally it changed many things. For starters, it introduced the term reasonable adjustments. But did the law go far enough? And just how easy is it to use? This is Doug Paulley. He's no lawyer, but he successfully sued public transport providers, universities, shops, pubs, and even a court. It's safe to say Doug has fully utilised the Disability Discrimination Act and he's written a guide to show others how to do it.
It's frustrating that it's not generally enforced or enforceable by disabled people because it's not got the mechanisms that would make it easy for disabled people to use. What's the point of it being there unless everybody who experiences discrimination can force change through it?
Despite its flaws, the bill was a remarkable moment in disability history. For those campaigners who worked tirelessly, it was a special time and a moment they were proud to be part of. But did it have the impact they'd hoped for?
Nearly 2016, and I still experience at least once a month, does he take sugar? I'm here, hello, you know. I don't actually, but...
And that's Jason ending that report. Nicky's here now. So, Jason, real character, obviously, and yeah. He's laughing, but what he's saying there illustrates something, doesn't it? What does it tell us?
Well, the bill that we've been talking about, the Disability Discrimination Act, it was a big deal, you know. It stopped disabled people from feeling utterly hopeless if they'd been discriminated against, you know. You've got to remember, this was a time, before 1995, where if you were sacked from your job because you'd acquired a disability, there was no comeback. That was it. Finito. Adios, nothing you could do about it, you know. And younger disabled people probably don't even remember a time when, you know, they could be refused entry to a nightclub and couldn't do anything, no protection whatsoever. So it was a big deal. It was, the bill itself was a lot weaker than many campaigners had hoped for, you know. They fought for it to be a bit tougher, but it was still it was a massive moment. It was a big deal.
There is still some way to go now, though, isn't there?
Yeah. I mean, amongst the celebration, and it is a celebration of this bill, 20 years, you know, there still are those voices saying, hang on a minute, you know, we've still got a fair way to go. There's still quite a few fights to be had. Now, the Disability, just, you know, to make a point, the Disability Discrimination Act is now fed into what is the Equality Act, which happened in 2010, which is a much broader act. But... you know, many would argue there is still quite a lot of work to do, but it is a moment to remember the hard work of all those campaigners that fought tirelessly during that time, you know, to get these rights for disabled people.
Nicki, lovely to talk to you. Nicki Fox, thank you very much indeed.